Interesting examples of addition of numbers from 10 to 20, part 1. So children, in the previous video, you learned to add numbers up to 20. In this video, we will see some more interesting examples of adding numbers up to 20. Chhotu and Sonu have brought their balls to play in the playground. Before playing, they started showing their balls to each other.
Wow, Chhotu, you have so many balls.
Yes, Sonu, I have 9 balls. How many do you have?
I have 4 balls in total.
So, how many balls do we have in all?
Children, do you know? Let us see. Chhotu has 9 balls and Sonu has 4 balls. This means that all the balls together make a group of 10 balls and 3 more balls. This means there are a total of 13 balls. So children, 9 balls added to 4 more balls make a total of 13 balls. So children, do you remember tens and ones? Here we have 13 balls. That is 1 tens in which there are 10 balls and 3 ones in which there are 3 balls. Children, today is Aarti's birthday. Aarti's friends are all busy preparing for her party. Neha is blowing balloons for the party.
Come on, Neha, I will also help you in blowing the balloons.
Children, Neha blew 12 balloons and Chhotu blew 4 balloons. Can you tell me how many total balloons did Chhotu and Neha blew together? Let us see. First of all, Neha blew 12 balloons and Chhotu blew 4 balloons. So children, if we see all balloons together, then we have 1 group of 10 balloons and 6 more balloons. That means we have a total of 16 balloons. Yes, children. So 12 and 4 balloons make a total of 16 balloons. So children, this means that when we add 12 and 4, then we get a total of 16. That is all for today. In this video, we saw some more interesting examples of adding numbers whose addition was between 10 to 20. In the next video, we will see some more interesting examples of adding numbers up to 20 and learn about some common mistakes that should not be made. Till then, goodbye, children. Interesting examples of addition of numbers from 10 to 20, part 1. So children, in the previous video, you learned to add numbers up to 20. In this video, we will see some more interesting examples of adding numbers up to 20. Chhotu and Sonu have brought their balls to play in the playground. Before playing, they started showing their balls to each other.
Wow, Chhotu, you have so many balls.
Yes, Sonu, I have 9 balls. How many do you have?
I have 4 balls in total.
So, how many balls do we have in all?
Children, do you know? Let us see. Chhotu has 9 balls and Sonu has 4 balls. This means that all the balls together make a group of 10 balls and 3 more balls. This means there are a total of 13 balls. So children, 9 balls added to 4 more balls make a total of 13 balls. So children, do you remember tens and ones? Here we have 13 balls. That is 1 tens in which there are 10 balls and 3 ones in which there are 3 balls. Children, today is Aarti's birthday. Aarti's friends are all busy preparing for her party. Neha is blowing balloons for the party.
Come on, Neha. I will also help you in blowing the balloons.
Children, Neha blew 12 balloons. And Chotu blew 4 balloons. Can you tell me how many total balloons did Chotu and Neha blew together? Let us see. First of all, Neha blew 12 balloons. And Chotu blew 4 balloons. So children, if we see all balloons together, then we have one group of 10 balloons and 6 more balloons. That means we have a total of 16 balloons. Yes, children. So 12 and 4 balloons make a total of 16 balloons. So children, this means that when we add 12 and 4, then we get a total of 16. That is all for today. In this video, we saw some more interesting examples of adding numbers whose addition was between 10 to 20. In the next video, we will see some more interesting examples of adding numbers up to 20 and learn about some common mistakes that should not be made. Till then, goodbye, children.
Interesting examples of addition of numbers from 10 to 20, part 2.
Hello friends, in the previous video we saw some interesting examples of addition of numbers up to 20. In this video we will see some more interesting examples of adding numbers up to 20 and learn about some common mistakes that should not be made. So children, do you know how important it is to plant trees? Yes. Today Chotu is planting saplings in the garden with his mother.
Look at this, Chotu. This is the way to plant saplings. After this, we have to water them.
Mom, even I want to plant saplings.
Chotu, now you also start planting the saplings carefully.
Chotu planted 4 saplings. Mother planted 9 saplings. Can you tell me how many saplings in all did they both plant? Let us see.
Chotu, can you count and tell me how many saplings we have planted?
We have planted 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Mom, we have planted 12 saplings in total.
Children, has Chotu counted correctly? Let us see.
No, Chotu, not like this. Come on now, let us count the saplings all over again. Look, first of all, you planted 4 saplings. After that, I planted 9 more saplings and we already had 4, and after 4, this is the 5th sapling. This is the 6th, then 7th, 8th, 9th, 10th, 11th, 12th, 13th. That means we planted 13 plants in total.
That is all for today. In this video, you learned to add numbers up to 20. I hope you have understood this topic very well. Goodbye, children.
Introduction to making bundles of 10 and counting from 10 to 20.
Hello friends, I am the parrot. Welcome to this topic. Come on, let us see what are we going to learn in this video. What is a bundle of 10 and how do we count objects more than 9? Chotu's mother needs some wooden sticks for a bonfire in the evening. Chotu gets some wooden sticks from the forest.
Chotu, can you count and tell me how many wooden sticks are there?
Yes, Mummy. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and I don't know how to count ahead. These are more than 9 wooden sticks.
Don't worry, Chotu. I will tell you how to count beyond 9. If we add one more wooden stick to 9 wooden sticks, then we get 10 wooden sticks.
I see.
Do you know, Chotu, that what is any group of 10 called?
No, Mummy. What do we call it?
Kids, do you know what is a group of 10 called? Come on, let us see.
Bundle of 10. This means that if the number of items is 10, then we can say that it is in a bundle of 10. Can you spot some objects in this room which are in a bundle of 10, Chotu?
Yes, Mummy. These are 10 glasses. So we can call their group a bundle of 10. Similarly, those books are also 10. So they are also making a bundle of 10. Right, Mummy?
Yes, Chotu. You are absolutely correct. Very good. Now let's count the remaining wooden sticks. These are 10 sticks. So let's make their bundle of 10 like this. One bundle of 10 and one more wooden stick make 11 wooden sticks. One bundle of 10 and two wooden sticks make 12 wooden sticks. One bundle of 10 and three wooden sticks make 13 wooden sticks. One bundle of 10 and four wooden sticks make 14 wooden sticks. One bundle of 10 and 5 wooden sticks make 15 wooden sticks. One bundle of 10 and 6 wooden sticks make 16 wooden sticks. One bundle of 10 and 7 wooden sticks make 17 wooden sticks. One bundle of 10 and 8 wooden sticks make 18 wooden sticks. One bundle of 10 and 9 wooden sticks make 19 wooden sticks. And one bundle of 10 and 10 more wooden sticks make 2 bundles of 10, and that makes 20 wooden sticks. So Chotu, as soon as we have 10 objects, we make their bundle and count open objects till 9. As soon as we get another wooden stick after 19, we make another bundle of 10, which gives us 2 bundles of 10.
That means I got 20 wooden sticks.
Yes, Chotu, you are absolutely correct. Now go and wash your hands.
You also count the number of objects around by making bundles of 10. So children, that was all for today. In this video, we learned what is a bundle of 10 and how do we count objects ahead of 9. In the next video, we will see some more examples of counting by making bundles of 10. Till then, bye friends!
Examples of counting from 10 to 20.
So children, in the previous video we learned how to make bundles of 10 and learned how to count objects more than 9 in number. In this video we will see some more interesting examples of how to count objects more than 9 in number by making bundles of 10. Chotu has won a lot of trophies in athletics. These trophies are kept on a table in his house. Today, Chotu and Aarti will be going to school together. So, Aarti is waiting at Chotu's place. And that time, she notices Chotu's table and by then, even Chotu comes ready for school.
Wow, Chotu, you have so many trophies.
Yes, Aarti. Every year, I participate in athletics in school. It is a lot of fun. Next year, you too participate. Now, let's quickly go to the school.
Yes, Chotu, let's go.
So, children, can you tell me how many trophies does Chotu have? Come on, let us count together. These are 10 trophies and we can make one bundle of 10 trophies. Apart from this, there are 4 more trophies. This means that Chotu has 1 bundle of 10 and 4 more trophies. That is 14 trophies in total. Even you had the same answer, right? Very good. Come on, now let us go to Chotu and Aarti school. A cleanliness drive is being carried out at their school today. For this, Chotu and Aarti have been assigned the job of collecting plastic bottles from their school and its surrounding areas. Come on, let us see how many bottles each of them have collected. First, let us count the number of bottles that Aarti has collected. These are 10 bottles. That is 1 bundle of 10. And there are 5 more bottles. So, a bundle of 10 and 5 are 15 bottles. This means that Aarti has collected a total of 15 bottles. Even you counted in the same way, right? So now let's count the number of bottles that Chotu has collected. This is 1 bundle of 10 bottles and this is another bundle of 10 bottles. These are 2 bundles of 10. So these are 20 bottles. This means that Chotu has collected a total of 20 bottles. Did you understand, children? Similarly, by making a bundle of 10 bottles, we can count till any number between 9 and 20. That was all for today. In this video, we counted objects more than 9 by making bundles of 10. In the next video, we will see few more examples and the commonly made mistakes that should be avoided while counting objects more than 9. Till then, bye friends!
Interesting examples and common mistakes while counting from 10 to 20.
So children, in the previous video, you counted objects by making bundles of 10. In this video, we will see some more examples and some common mistakes that should be avoided while counting objects that are more than 9 in number. Today is Pinky and Chotu's parents' wedding anniversary. And that's why Pinky and Chotu decide to make a card for their parents. Pinky needs some objects to make the card and she makes a list of these objects.
Chotu, we need all of these objects to make a card. Can you go quickly and get all these objects from the nearby shop, please? Meanwhile, I will start making the card. Okay, Pinky, I will go and get them.
Chotu quickly gets the object and returns. He has brought 2 different colored sheets of paper, 3 colorful ribbons and 8 colorful pens.
Here you go, Pinky. Oh no, Chotu, you just got 3 ribbons and 8 pens. This is too less. Did you not read the list properly?
But Pinky, this was what written in the list.
No, Chotu, show me the list.
See this, Pinky.
Children, out of Pinky and Chotu, who do you think is correct? Come on, let's see.
See, first 2 sheets of paper is written in the list, which you have brought correctly. Tell me what is written below that.
1 and 2, which means 3 colorful ribbons.
Oh no, Chotu, you added 1 and 2. We don't read this number like this. Here 1 means 1 bundle of 10. That means 10 ribbons. And 2 means 2 more ribbons. So in total it becomes 12 ribbons. Understood?
Oh, I see. Oh no, I read the number of pens also incorrectly. I added 1 and 7 and that's why I got 8 pens.
So now can you tell me the correct number of pens?
Yes, 1 means 1 bundle of 10 and 7 means 7 more pens. So total 17 pens. Right, Pinky?
Yes, Chotu, you are absolutely right.
Come on, I will quickly go and get more pens and ribbons.
Okay, Chotu, thank you.
So children, now even you can read 2-digit numbers correctly like Chotu. Right? Come on, let's look at another example. These are some flowers. The number of these flowers is written below them. Can you identify and tell me this number? Yes, this is one bundle of 10 flowers and 9 more flowers. That means in total 19 flowers. Very good, children. That was all for today. In this video, we saw some more examples and common mistakes while counting objects that are more than 9 in number, and also saw how to write 2-digit numbers. I hope you have understood this topic very well. Bye, friends.
Comparison of numbers from 10 to 20.
Hello friends, I am the parrot. Welcome to this lesson. Today in this lesson we will learn comparing numbers from 10 to 20. Today there is a competition in the jungle between two monkeys, Minnie and Motu. There are some bananas, and the monkey who eats the most bananas will win. To prevent anyone from cheating, the two monkeys have called Dear Didi to watch the competition and count the bananas. Let's see who eats more bananas.
Come on, Minnie, come on, eat faster.
Okay, the bananas have finished. Now let's count who has eaten more bananas. First, let's count how many bananas Minnie has eaten. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and 13. This means that Minnie has eaten 13 bananas. Come on now, let's count the number of bananas Motu ate. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So that's equal to the number of bananas Minnie ate. But there are 14th and the 15th banana also. This means Motu ate 2 bananas more than Minnie. Minnie ate 13 bananas and Motu ate 15 bananas. 15 bananas are more than 13 bananas. And this means that Motu has eaten 2 bananas more than Minnie.
Motu is very happy to hear this. Yay, I have won.
That is when two squirrels, Timmy and Miku, come to the deer.
Dear Didi, can you all come with us and tell between both of us whose tree has more mangoes?
Okay, let's go.
This is Miku's tree and this is my tree.
Miku's tree has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 and 14 mangoes. And Timmy's tree has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. That's equal to the number of mangoes in Miku's tree. But there are more, 15 and 16 mangoes. This means Timmy's tree has 2 mangoes more than Miku's tree. 16 mangoes are more than 14 mangoes. And so, there are 2 more mangoes on Timmy's tree.
Yay! I told you, Miku, that I have more mangoes on my tree. I have fun!
So, children, did you have fun watching this competition? Now, you too can compare numbers like Dear Didi. Good! That's all for today. In this video, we learned how to compare numbers from 10 to 20. In the next video, we will see some more examples of comparing these numbers. Till then, bye friends!
Examples of comparing numbers from 10 to 20.
So children, in the previous video we learned how to compare numbers from 10 to 20. In this video, we will see some examples of comparing these numbers. Today there is a puja at Chotu and Pinky's house. Their mother needs some flowers for the puja.
Pinky and Chotu, will you please bring some flowers from the garden? Just bring those flowers that have fallen. Do not pluck the flowers.
Okay, Mom.
Chotu and Pinky go to the garden and collect fallen flowers and then come back to their mother.
Mom, take the flowers.
Thank you, children.
Mom, I brought more flowers.
No, I brought more flowers, isn't it, Mom?
Don't quarrel, children. Let's find out who brought more flowers. First, let's see how many flowers Chotu has brought. These are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12 flowers. That means Chotu has brought 12 flowers. Now let us see how many flowers Pinky has brought. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. That is equal to the number of flowers Chotu has brought. But there are 13, 14, 15, 16, and 17 flowers. This means Pinky has brought 17 flowers.
17 flowers are more than 12 flowers. Therefore, I brought more flowers, isn't it, Mom?
Yes, Pinky, you are absolutely correct.
Yay!
Oho, no problem. I will bring even more flowers next time.
Come on, let's now quickly distribute these sweets among all the neighbors. I will keep the sweets in two plates.
Okay, Mom.
Then Pinky picks up a plate and Chotu picks up another plate. And both of them go to distribute sweets.
Chotu, let us see that whose plate has more sweets.
Okay, Pinky. First, let us count the number of sweets in your plate.
Okay, Chotu.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. There are 11 sweets in your plate.
Okay, Chotu. Now you count the number of sweets in your plate.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. That's equal to the number of sweets in your plate. But there are more, 12 and 13 sweets.
I see. That means 13 sweets are more than 11 sweets. So you have more sweets in your plate.
Yes, Pinky. Come on, let's distribute all the sweets to our neighbors.
So children, in these examples, you saw how Pinky and Chotu compared the two numbers and found out which number is greater. You can also compare the number of such objects around you, right? Good! So children, that is all for today. In this video, we compared numbers from 10 to 20. In the next video, we will see some more examples of comparing these numbers and some common mistakes related to them. Till then, bye friends!
Examples and common mistakes while comparing numbers from 10 to 20.
So children, in the previous video, we learned to compare numbers from 10 to 20. In this video, we will see some more examples of comparing numbers from 10 to 20 and some common mistakes related to them. Choto and Pinky went to the market with their mother to buy sports t-shirts resembling their favorite player's t-shirt. Choto bought a football player's t-shirt and Pinky bought a cricket player's t-shirt. Then both went to the garden to play.
The number written on my t-shirt is greater than the number on yours.
Really? But how is 8 greater than 12?
Come on, Chotu. 12 has 1 and 2 in it. And 8 is greater than these two. So 8 is greater than 12.
But Pinky, 12 has 1 10 and 2 ones. And 8 has only 8 ones and not a single 10.
Okay, you collect 12 leaves and I will collect 8 leaves. And then let us see who has more leaves. Okay, Chotu, you do it first.
Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Here are 8 leaves. Come on, now you collect 12 leaves.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's equal to the number of leaves you collected. But there are 9, 10, 11 and 12 leaves.
So now tell me, what do you think? 8 leaves are more or 12 leaves are more?
12 leaves. This means that your t-shirt has a greater number written on it than my t-shirt.
Yes, Pinky, you are absolutely right. Let's play now.
So children, you saw that 12 is greater number than 8. Because 12 has a 10, which means 10 items like 10 leaves. And 2 units meaning 2 single items. Like 2 leaves. So total is 10 and 2, 12 leaves. And 8 has 0 tens and 8 units, which means 8 single items such as 8 leaves. Therefore, 2 digit numbers such as 12 are greater than single digit numbers such as 8. Did you understand, kids? That's all for today. In this video, we learned how to compare numbers from 10 to 20. And 2-digit numbers are greater than single-digit numbers. I hope you have understood this topic properly. Bye, friends.